on Chai because he beat Liam 3 times.
I'm not a fan of him either.
No, no, so we'll slag him off. Yeah. Not only joking, you can't help but admire the guy.
Nah, he is the best out of the last 15 years. He's absolutely amazing. Been in there with everyone. He always gives away weight as well. This fight will be up at, I'm guessing, 65. Victor usually fights up to 67, 68, 69 kilos. This fight will probably be around 65, 66. Fanchat usually fights to 60, 61 in the stadiums. He's an absolute genius in that ring. But Victor, he's going to be out for revenge. He lost the first fight in the Toyota tournament. Very aggressive performance from Sanchai. You don't usually see him like that. Victor will be out for some good revenge here. But I'd say he's beaten Fabio Pinker. Been in there with Superbon and Bovi and other big names like that. He fights on all the big shows in Thailand.
You know, I've never seen Victor, but what do you say his second name?
Nagabe.
I've never seen Victor Nagabe fight before, and I've been wearing the Union Jack gloves. I've never seen him fight before, and you know what? So good to see these new kids on the block coming through. And I've never seen Victor before, and I'm going to be really, really interested to watch him fight Sanchai. But let's be honest, you have to be really truthful. Sanchai is Red Connor, a bit special, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He's not got a weakness anywhere, really. If he is, it's he'll lose against the big, tall clinch fighters in the stadiums in Thailand. But even then, it's giving away a lot of weight. But against the foreign fighters, it's going to be a difficult task for him.
You know, out of all the world, out of all the Westerners in the world, I think I've commentated on Sanchai. Welcome,
Sanchai. I think I've commentated on quite a few of his fights as well.
Yeah, you have with me as well. So, and I've seen him fight you, and I've commentated on one of them ones live anyway. Unfortunately, I couldn't be at the first one to be Holland. But he is an exciting fighter, and he does disco. He can annoy me, to be honest, Sanchai, because I love his skills. I like it when he fights. I like it when he really puts his thing together and he stamps authority. When he starts dancing and moving around, a lot of people like it. I'm not a fan of disco dancing, to be honest, only in disco.
Yeah, I know. It can be a bit frustrating sometimes when you see someone as good and as skilled as this, just playing around. Like I said, though, in the last fight against Victor, he was very, very aggressive. He hurt Victor a few times, some solid low kicks and some solid punches. So hopefully today we'll see him top of his game, and hopefully he'll mean business.
Yeah, he's good in rematches, Sanchai, isn't he? He does well in rematches as well. When he does lose, he just seems to do well in rematches.
Yeah, he does. Like I said, though, Victor's going to be out for revenge.
Who's beat Sanchai? Your Witcher?
Your Witcher beat him, Pet Boonchu's beat him, Sagatow's beat him, but against Sagatow, I think Sanchai.
Singdam beat him as well?
I think that was something like 4-1 to Sanchai against Singdam, though. It might even be a lot more. I think about 5-2 or something like that. I could be wrong. They fought plenty of times. 65 kilos this one.
I mean, look at that record. I mean, you know, it's absolutely phenomenal, is it? It's probably more than that, isn't it, to be fair?
Yeah, probably. Been fighting probably every once a week when he was on his way up through the ranks as a small boy in the stadiums, into the temples, etc. in Thailand, and now he even still fights. Now, I think last year he had something.
Didn't he start off with Somrat Kamsing? One of his first coaches, Somrat's. Was it Old West Gym that Somrat had? What was Somrat's gym called?
I forgot.
Old West, wasn't it? Do you remember he had the hat on the shorts? Yeah. Sorry, me and Liam, boring you there, ladies and gentlemen, with a bit of nostalgia. But I'm interested in watching Victor Nagabe.
Good, very good slick southpaw. He's very tough. He has been in there with some good fighters, some big names.
He's beat Pinker, who's actually beat Sanchai. Pinker did beat Sanchai. Yeah, didn't he did. On a Yokao show.
Yeah, he did. A very questionable defeat, though, to be honest, that one. Victor and Pinker are a very good fighter. Victor, he's very slick, he's a good southpaw. He's been in there with Bovi, he's been in there with Superbon, he's been in there with Sagatow. Although he lost them, he put in a good account of himself. Put in a good account of himself last time against Sanchai. He's very dangerous.
What you got to understand as well, ladies and gentlemen, if you lose to these guys that are at this level, it doesn't ruin your career, because they're so more vastly experienced that you do take something from it. I mean, I'm sure the battles you've had with Sanchai, the three you've had, the fights you had with Sagatow, I'm not going to go on and on and on about your career, Liam. We'd be here all night, couldn't we? And we'd miss the fights then. But you must have gained something from each fight.
From every loss, there's something constructive to come out of it. You've got to take a positive away. If you didn't, there'd be no point in really fighting at all. Really, if there's something that constructive that come from every loss and every win, you've got to keep learning if you want to improve. And fighting these top guys like Victor's doing now, he's only going to improve his game. 20 yeah. years old as well.
He's going to be something. You know, this kid's still got time to develop, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has, without doubt. And living in Thailand and staying at the M&A gym, which I think is where he's from, he's only going to get better.
Yeah. Having said that, you know, Sanchai just beat Andrei Kulabin, who Liam absolutely destroyed. And he wasn't meant to, was he? Let's be honest, you know, a lot of people...
I was meant to, I don't think people thought I would. That's
yeah, we knew the people in the, you know, the people that are close to you know, because, you know, we're very good friends. And I knew what the battle plan was, and we worked out a little bit of thing. And Richard Smith, your coach, has kindly let me in on the battle plan. It worked absolutely superbly, but... Battle plan seemed to go out the window with Sanchai because he changes it up, doesn't he? You think he doesn't do something often. He just changes it up all the time.
Yeah,
doesn't he?
This guy ain't a fighter. He's an adapter. He can adapt to any situation you put him in. He's a genius in that ring. You might think one round you're gonna go try kick him. He'll adapt. You might want to go try clinch him. He'll throw you on the floor. He has got an answer for everything.
Right. I really like that saying. He's not a fighter. He's an adapter. So we're going to say, so anyway, if you've never seen Sanchai before, do not move. Sit there. Be quiet. I'll keep talking because that's what I'm paid for. And the hitman, Liam Harrison, will be giving you the insight as in the red shorts. Sanchai PK, Sanchai Muay Thai Gym. We'll just call him Sanchai. He's been called Sanchai Saw Kingstar, Sanchai, etc. He's been called a million things. But we're going to call him Sanchai this one. And Victor Nagabi from Australia, who I'm very privileged to watch. So, big fan of yours now, Victor, because if you're getting in with a guy like this, you obviously can do the sport.
He's also fought, he had a close loss to Cal Fairtex as well, Victor.
Right.
He fought big names.
Yeah, only 20 years of age, so a baby in the sport. So, as we come up to this final fight in this absolutely sparkling show here at Pattaya Yokhao 7, the main man himself, the Muay Thai maestro, the adapter, not the fighter, as my friend Liam Harrison said. I like that. I'm going to keep that, Liam. Sorry. I'll pretend I'll tell everyone else. Sanchai versus Victor Nagabi in the white shorts. I'm looking forward to this. Southpaw versus Southpaw. Highest level skills and a KO bonus to boot. 3 3-minute rounds. Full Muay Thai rules. Yokhao 7.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see if Sanchai fights aggressive like he did in the first time, especially with his KO bonus on the line. Both these guys know what the other one's got. Big size difference there. With Victor being a lot bigger, but it's nothing Sanchai's not used to. He's always giving away weight. Whether it's against Thais, foreigners, don't really matter to him.
You see, sometimes when you see Sanchai fight, he just seems in trouble at first. And then he just starts just doing stuff and landing his shots. He really does have a look. He studies things, doesn't he?
He does, yeah. And even
good eyes.
Even if sometimes you have to take a few shots and you think, why is he doing that? It's just to get a good
look.
A good look at him, yeah. See the angle, the shots coming in, and he does sometimes just take a few. Beautiful movement there, start the way of that body shot.
Good elbow by Victor there to try to top of the head of Sanchai. He's not slowing down, he's old for a Thai, isn't he?
He's about 33 now, I think, but he's still fighting at the top level, so...
It's unusual, that, isn't it? It really is unusual. And it proves that he keeps himself in good nick, doesn't he?
Yeah.
You know, not getting hit too much. And
he
know.
Does, he's had, although he's had a lot of fights, he hasn't done too much damage in these fights.
He lives the sport, doesn't he, as well? There's a bit of a... Yeah, the shuffle just doesn't work with Victor, he's not going to fall for that.
Nah, he's seen all these before. Nice right hook over the top there from Victor.
It was very nice. He's got a good chin, Sanchai, though, hasn't he? He's been whacked on it a few times. He's got a good chin.
Yeah, he has a very good chin. I've whacked him a few good times on it and he took them all.
He knew, though, in fights with you, Liam, that he was not going to come out unscathed. He knew that. He even said that, didn't he, publicly?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, beautiful takedown there from Turner. He's just embarrassed himself, though.
So much smaller, though, doesn't he, than Nagabi?
Yeah, like I say, Nagabi's fought up to 69 kilos, so he's going to have a big, big weight advantage.
Sharp skills. Only 20 years of age. Ridiculous, this. Good kids coming through. Jostling for position, just having a look.
Nice knee from Victor there.
It was nice knee.
Been a tentative starting it. Still tentative starting this opening round for both guys.
He's just looking to lift the front leg, isn't he? Throw the 1-2 punch, Victor. Trying to catch Sanchai unaware, trying to get his hands down and throw that, hit him with that shot, that left hand. Elbow, good elbow. See, this is what Sanchai looks like. It'll be sort of like, oh, he's getting beat here, and then he will just up it and then just start picking people apart. That's what he does.
Yeah, he is. Like I say, has a good look at him, and then nice scoring. Kick there from Sanchai, in and out very fast.
Round one. Very good round for Victor. But let me tell you, watch the second round. He will come out with something, Sanchai, and he'll start picking himself apart. He's like an artist, isn't he? He's like a painter. He just picks his colours, and you're the canvas. He picks his colours. He starts putting his scenery around you, and then starts stabbing you with all sorts of horrible different spots. I don't know what he does. That was the worst thing I've ever said on commentary. I have to admit, but I hope you get what I'm trying to talk about. Anyway, round two then. I'll just get rescued back. Round two then, Liam, and a good round for Victor.
Yeah, I thought we're pretty close round for both guys, really. Neither of them unloaded with anything too serious in that first round. Hopefully, we'll see one of them going for that KO bonus in this round. Liven the action up a bit. It was the second round in the first fight between these two where Sanchez really came alive. He put in some scathing low kicks, some hard punches, and he had Victor in a bit of trouble in the first fight.
Don't forget, Yokao 8 very, very soon from England, Bolton. We've seen some big, big names on that one, so look out for the Yokao 8 when you get to see that one. I guarantee I'm really looking forward to that. It's going to be very exciting. But nevertheless, in the white shorts, Victor Nagabe, who's a new person for me to watch, who I'm enjoying very much. Like Liam said, a very talented kid, only 20 years of age. He's a 33-year-old, we predict. 33-year-old in the red shorts, Sanchai, who is known the world over. And watch him now start to put things together. You just must think it's great. The first round, you think, yeah, I've got him. And then all of a sudden, he starts magic, punching you in the face and kicking you in on a regular basis. And as Liam said, I'm glad I'm too old to fight. Thank God. So, round two then. Yokao 7, Sanchai versus Nagabe.
I've not seen any time trying to impose himself on Sanchai. He's trying to use his size, use the advantage he's got.
Yeah. His head down underneath Sanchai's chin. Nagabe just... Sanchai has lost to good clinchers, hasn't he? Him up and negate him, but it's still not easy to try to get this slippery old fox. Monkey climb up Nagabe. He's not showboating though, is he, Liam? He's took Nagabe seriously.
No, he has. Yeah, he knows Victor's he's a good caliber fighter. He's been in there with good fighters. He knows what to expect.
Good balance. Look at that. Superb balance. But he's strong though, Victor, isn't he?
Yeah, he's very strong. He'll be a pro.
And he's not got man strength yet. I mean, he's only 20. So yeah, he's not got man strength. He's 25 in that. This kid's going to be...
I think he'll be up there about 70, 72 kilos when he gets to that weight. He'll go up the weight a bit.
Yeah. It's going to be a problem for everyone, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, he is, yeah. Nice sneaky elbow inside.
From Victor. He's doing well, isn't he?
Yeah, he is, yeah. He's doing a lot better than he did in the first
fight. He's halfway through the fight, and, you know, he's scoring better than Sanchai is at the minute. So we'll see Sanchai can pull up. That's a nice knee, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, beautiful step-up knee. Oh, nice elbow as well.
Very sneaky. Good big knees going in, not really causing any damage. His own little shuffle, Victor. Good score. Very nice. He's balancing very, very good at that, isn't he?
Yeah, very sneaky with that one.
He has lost a lot of snap, though, hasn't he, Liam? I mean, he's not like the Sanchai of 2 or 3 years ago, I believe. I mean, you know, he's still very good, but he's not... I believe he's on the decline a little bit.
Yeah, obviously, he's getting to 33 years old. He's had a lot of fights. He's I don't think his body's going to allow him to train like he did remember even 5 years ago when he was like 28, 29.
But it's nevertheless, he's still good, isn't he? He's still scoring here.
Nice knee, last left kick. See how fast he was then, in and out.
Really nice. Scoring big in this round.
Yeah, he's just starting to pull away just slightly towards the end of the round. Nice knee,
and
good block as well.
Considering though, Liam, I mean, he's fighting a kid that's 65 kilos, and he's like at least 5 kilos out of his weight category, isn't he? Maybe even six.
Yeah, I'm not sure what weight Victor will be today. He looks very, very big, very muscular, very strong. Only 20 years old as well. So he's obviously going to be very, very big at that weight, very fit, very strong. So it's going to be a struggle for Sanchai, but he's just did pull away a little bit towards the end of that round there.
Yeah, well, Uma Samata earlier really impressed me from Uganda. And Victor Ngabi also, sounds like an African name anyway, Ngabi as well, so maybe he's originally
I think he is from African descent. And
right. But he lives in Australia. Yeah. Superb talents, these young men coming through. Obviously we know Sanchai, but some of the names, and you know, Yokao, six, and I keep going on about in the young man, Matthias from Sitsonpil, he was very good as well. Some good kids coming through, England. Some very, very good kids, Jordan Williams. I believe you've got a young kid at your gym, Jordan.
Joe Craven.
Yeah, Joe Craven that's just joined you. He's a very, very good fighter. So one to watch, eyes peeled for the kids that are coming through. But nevertheless, we're watching a bit of a maestro performance. Not a virtuoso performance, really, off Sanchai, to be fair. But still, a workmanlike progress.
Yeah, he's just doing...
He's doing enough, isn't he?
Just enough, yeah. Victor's obviously trying to push the pace a little bit, but he's very difficult against someone like Sanchai.
It's what he does. It's the little things he does, Liam, isn't it? The little skills you don't see. Like a sneak elbow there, and just how he defends himself, lifting his hands up and pushing his head backwards. Clever. So here we go then, round three. This final fight, this superb show we've had here at Yokao 7. Sanchai versus Victor Ngabi. Victor Ngabi in the white shorts and Sanchai in the red.
Yep, it's all a play for again in this third round. A big round here from Victor could still help take the fight. Sanchai's going to want to protect that little lead he just built up at the end of the second round though. Good knees coming in there from Victor. Yeah. Using his size. Pulls himself on Sanchai.
He's still going forward though, Victor, isn't he? Going for broke. There's the cartwheel kick, and that landed really well, didn't it?
Beautiful there. Absolutely great timing. Right across the head and the neck of Victor.
If you watch YouTube, you can see Sanchai knock someone out in sparring. In Norway with that
Super Todd.
Yeah, Super Todd. He knocks him spark out. So there's a good left cross, but a good high kick there from Sanchai. Look at Victor still coming forward though. He's got a strong kid, this one.
Yeah, he's very, very strong. A beautiful little push away there.
Just unbalancing him there as well with the leg kick, a high kick as well from Sanchai. He's got it sus now, hasn't he?
Yeah,
he's got his position, he's got his movement. He knows where Victor's coming from. Just negates everything coming up to the last minute and 20 seconds of this. Sanchai just scoring. It's not a really, you know, a very amazing performance from Sanchai, but it's a good performance nevertheless. Victor comes in with an own right hook. This kid's good. This kid's a threat. He's going to be anyway. He's only 20 years of age. Keep going, keep learning, keep improving.
Sanchai's very fast in and out there.
Good eyesight, hasn't he?
Yeah, he has. He's just still pushing him, still looking to box him though. He knows he's gone behind on the scorecards now, still looking to claw something back.
Victor really coming forward all the time, swinging shots at Sanchai. He's just moving off the back foot, knows the ring so well, been in there so many times. Just defending himself, lifting his arms up, pushing back, moving around, lateral movement, superb.
Yeah, he's been a
It's not been a virtuoso performance, has it, by Sanchez, but a workmanlike performance.
Yeah, yeah, he's just done what he's had to do. Beautiful takedown there.
Yeah.
Noses ahead, protecting the lead, protecting himself, not taking too much damage again.
Good knee. Big scores.
Yeah, Victor has really pushed him. He's made Sanchez really work for
him.
Yeah,
he has.
I think Sanchez got it, but he's been made to work for it.
Yeah. Good performance there by both boxers. Really nice performance from Victor. A strong performance and really tried his best. But is that Super Toad in the corner?
I don't know, I'm not sure.
Of Sanchai. Of Victor, anyway, I don't know. But a really good performance by Victor. A strong performance and a learning curve for him on his quest to be to the elite of Muay Thai, to get to the position that the man next to me is already in. But I'd say a win for Sanchai and a workmanlike performance, but not a virtuoso one, but still a win.
Nah. Yeah, he did what he had to do. There we go. Sanchai has got the win.
Yep.
He did what he had to do. He's pushed all the way by that. The young, hungry Victor. I'm sure we're going to see him again. He's going to be a force to be reckoned with, no doubt.
Oh, so very soon. Well, we've really enjoyed this show and hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have here on Yokao 7. I've been Vinny Shulman, and with me, very privileged. Thank you very much, Liam, for giving us his insight and his expertise. And don't forget, keep your eyes peeled for Yokao 7. Sorry, Yokao 8 in the UK. That's going to be coming up very soon as well. So I'd like to thank the ladies and gentlemen at home. And don't forget, you can follow us on www.yokao.com. And also, you can find us on Twitter at Yokao Boxing. Thank you very much, and we'll see you very, very soon.
Safe home tonight. Good night.